Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the 1540 Committee, I would like to thank the organizer of this International Conference on Nuclear Security, or ICONS 2020, for inviting me to speak. I'm very sorry for not having been able to attend in person. Nuclear security matters are an important element of Resolution 1540 by United Nations member states. Thus, the outcome of this important meeting will be closely observed by the committee. Resolution 1540 is a vital component of the global non-proliferation architecture. Its objective is to prevent the proliferation of nuclear, chemical, and biological weapons, particularly weapons of mass destruction, to and by non-state actors, including terrorists. Full and effective implementation of the resolution is in principle crucial to preventing potentially catastrophic consequences that could result from the use of this weapon by non-state actors. Resolution 1540 defines non-state actors as individuals or entities not acting under the lawful authority of any states in conducting activities which come within the scope of the resolution. These activities are manufacturing, acquiring, possessing, developing, transporting, transferring, or using WMD and their means of delivery, as well as attempts to engage in such activities, to participate in them as an accomplice, to assist, or to finance them. Non-state actors could include, therefore, as well as terrorists, manufacturers, traders, financiers, or any other types of individuals or entities. Resolution 1540, aspects specific to nuclear security include requirements that states take and enforce effective measures to establish domestic controls, to prevent the proliferation of WMD, their means of delivery, and related materials. International legal instruments for nuclear security are thus very relevant to 1540. States should develop and maintain appropriate and effective measures to account for and secure such items in production, use, storage, or transport, and to develop and maintain appropriate, effective physical protection measures. It is for states to decide what exactly are appropriate and effective measures. In the 15 years since the adoption of Resolution 1540 in 2004, 108 out of 193 UN member states have reported to the 1540 Committee on their implementation of the resolution. This is a high level of reporting and an indicator of the importance states attach to the resolution. All the reports and much other useful material can be read on the 1540 Committee website. The mandate of the 1540 Committee will expire on 25 April 2021, and we are now conducting this year a comprehensive review. The committee will hold a number of events in 2020, most particularly open consultation in New York in June, during which states, as well as international, regional, and sub-regional organizations and civil society will be invited to contribute. I and the committee look forward to seeing the outcomes of your discussion at this conference. I'm sure that they will be available to the committee in identifying and analyzing challenges that may need to be considered in the 1540 comprehensive review. It is vital that Resolution 1540 remains fit for purpose as the centerpiece of international efforts to prevent the acquisition and exploitation of weapons of mass destruction by non-state actors. I thank you.